the weather at my place has been really very nice since the past couple of days. There has been rain, thunderstorm, and I thought why not to make a video on weather application. So if you open Google Play Store, there are already plenty of options on the weather applications, and this video will help you out in selecting the best weather app that you can have in your phone. So let's start with the video. So the first application on the list is called Today Weather, and first let me change the theme from light to dark. So as you open this application, the first thing that you find on the top is temperature, the maximum temperature and the minimum temperature. Below that you have the 24-hour forecast. And then as you scroll up a little bit, what you come across is this big sponsored ad, which actually takes up a lot of space right at the center of the screen. I think this is really a very weird position to place the ad. Then as you scroll up a little bit, what you find is the details section. And in the details section, what I was expecting was the section for precipitation, which is unfortunately not there. Then when you scroll up further a little bit, you find the 7-day weather forecast, and then you have the section of precipitation. So first of all, the ad is very weird. And second thing is that if you are living in a place where it rains a lot, then I think precipitation is something that is really important. So this section should have been somewhere beside the temperature or under the temperature. When you will enter the forecast section, you will notice that a lot of information is mentioned in words. Now, no one has time to read all that. Instead, everything should be made more graphical. Apart from that, what I like in this section is the small animations on those icons. But those icons are really so small that those animations are barely visible. So I request the developer to just increase the icon size a little bit. So the application is quite okay, but it is not what I was looking for. The next app on the list is a very popular weather app called Yahoo Weather. So when you will launch the application, it gives you information about the current weather. Fortunately, at the time of filming the video, it was raining outside, so I was able to catch that rain animation on the screen, and that cloudy wallpaper in the background gives you the actual feeling of rain and that cold weather. Yahoo Weather is exactly similar to Today's Weather. In fact, each and every section you will find in this app are same as the previous app. Like for example, on the top you have the 24-hour weather section. Below that you have the 5-day or 10-day weather forecast. Now, good thing about the forecast section is whenever the chances of rain are too high, it displays that in percentage. Then below that you have the details section. Then below that you have the precipitation section, then wind. So the app is kind of very similar to Today's Weather. Now in this particular clip, you didn't saw any kind of ad, but in this particular clip, you will see that a sponsored ad is exactly at the same location as they were in the Today's Weather. So both the applications are exactly the same, and let's move ahead. The next app on the list is called One Weather, and as you will launch the application, it will present you with a weather fact. Now this thing can be disabled by going in the settings section. So when you will come on the main page, the first thing that caught my attention was the section of precipitation, which is exactly there where it should be. Apart from that, as you will scroll up a little bit, you will come across an ad. Now this ad is not static, it's actually a video ad, and every time when you will open this application, you will come across this ad. You have to see this ad all the time. I still tried to browse the application. I was checking various sections, and I was also going through all the tabs that were on the top. I just felt like application is too bulky, and then at this instant I was again presented with an ad. So it was quite a very disappointing experience. Won't recommend this app to anyone. Let's move ahead. So the next app on the list is called Clean Weather, and as per its name, the UI of the application is really very clean. So on the top, it's showing you the chances of precipitation, and below that you have your temperature and then maximum and minimum temperature. Then as you move down a little bit more details have been given about the weather, like pressure, wind and humidity. Then below that you have the 24-hour weather section, which is represented in form of icons. Now you can tap each and every icon to get a little bit more detail about the weather. Then below that you have a dedicated precipitation section. Then below that you have the 7-day weather forecast, and then wind, pressure, etc. Now my favorite section in this application is the section of forecast. As you enter this section, you find nothing written in words. Everything is graphical. You get your temperature, you get those icons that tell you about the weather, and on the extreme left you have been given chances of precipitation, which is mentioned in percentage. So overall, a very nice application. Definitely try this one. So the next app on the list is a very compact weather application called Foreca. So as you open this application, you get the weather of your location and then two more locations depending upon its distance from the weather station, which is quite interesting. The app is displaying the weather forecast on day-to-day basis, and if you want to have the hourly weather forecast, then just go on that particular day and it will display each and everything related to what's going to happen on that particular day. It was quite interesting to see that the application is quite very original. They haven't copied anything from anywhere. It's an it's like a very well thought layout, and they are displaying a lot of information in that small space. The application is really very colorful, and the only thing that you can change here is the theme. So just go into the settings, and here you can change the theme from light to dark or dark to light. In fact, in dark theme as well, I found that the background is blue and they are using red and yellow color, but it's quite interesting. Apart from that, definitely give it a try. It's a nice app. So the next app on the list is called OverDrop, and this is one of the cleanest weather application that I'm reviewing in this video. So as soon as you open this application, you get a straightforward information about temperature, precipitation, and wind speed. Wind speed is important. Below that you have your hourly weather section, and in that also you get three tabs like temperature, wind, and rain. And I think rain and temperature are the most necessary ones. So the developer knows like what are the sections that are necessary and which are the ones that need to be highlighted. If you are looking for more details, you can click that toggle on the top right corner, and here it will open a drop down to give you more information. Apart from that, if you scroll up, there you get your forecast section, and everything is very neat and clean and precise in this section as well. And if you want more information, then you can again hit those toggles and it will open up a drop down from where you can get more information. The only drawback of this application is that this is a paid app. This is the trial version that I'm using. So from the top right corner, if you want to go into the widget section or theme section, so from here you can't use anything. You have to buy a paid subscription plan to use the widgets, which is quite disappointing. But overall, it's a very nice application, a very well thought application, and if you're willing to spend money on this, then it's up to you. So the next app on the list is called Weather, and I kind of have mixed opinions about this app. So first of all, at first instant, when you look at this app, it looks very neat and clean, but I kind of find very difficult fetching the information from this application. So as you can see that we are in the daily forecast section, and on the top they have given these kind of tabs. I'll go into the precipitation tab because that's the most important one. And here you will see that on the day when it's going to rain, the icon is showing that it's going to rain. But I don't know what that green color bar graph actually mean, what are those numbers written on that particular day. Apart from that, on the bottom line, you will notice that they have everywhere these kind of dots. Now, I don't know what these kind of dots actually mean. So you have to actually tap on that dot, and then it will open up this kind of a page. Now on this page as well, everything is written in white color. I think they should have used some kind of color coding to catch the attention, or you can say to differentiate between the sections. Apart from that, if you go in the hourly forecast section, then you will notice that it displays about the weather of first 4 hours, like they are showing sun in this case, and after that they are showing everything in dots. I don't know whether it's a lack of icons or what they actually want. So overall, I'm not comfortable with this application. Let's move on to the next app. So the last app on the list and one of my favorite one is called Eye in the Sky. So this app used to be there on Google Play Store, but now it isn't. So you can download the app from link given in the description box. So as you will open this application, it gives you a very brief view about temperature, humidity, and wind. I wish precipitation should have been included in this section. Then below that, you have been given forecast of next 4 days. So you can just tap on that and it will open up a page in detail. You can swipe right to access the weather for next 48 hours, and here it will show you the precipitation, which is quite important. And you can swipe left to access the information about the weather of next 15 days. By now you might have noticed that the application is not that descriptive. I mean, it does not believe in writing too much in words, but one of the most powerful feature of this application is its icon sets and widgets. So if you go into the icon set section from the top right corner, you will notice that you have been given plenty of icon sets, and you won't find these kind of app icon sets in any of the other application. And the next important feature is this widgets. So if you're trying to place any widget on the home screen, you can change parameters like icon sets, you can change the label, you can change the transparency. And if I talk about the practical usage of all these weather applications, then most of us would be using these apps in the form of widgets. So this is something that is really very important, and this is something that you will find only in this particular weather app. Out of these 8 weather applications, the 3 that I would like to recommend are the Forka Weather, the Clean Weather, and of course the Eye in the Sky. Apart from that, do let me know about what weather apps you are using in your phone, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care. I hope you like the video. Stay home and stay safe.